The clinical scenario that goes with this condition is gradually increasing shortness of breath with harsh, noisy inspiratory breathing. It sounds like subsequently, there is usually discovery of an unexplained inflammatory stenosis. I'm going to take you on a video tour of this kind of lesion now. We begin at the level of the vocal folds of this patient with the shortness of breath and harsh breathing noise. Go between those vocal folds and down into the subglottis below, where you see an intensely inflamed narrowing or stenosis. The caliber here is only about 40% of normal. When I take up a bit of this with my scope during the exam, the patient is even more short of breath. Beyond the stenosis, you can see the trachea, which has a normal caliber and no inflammation. Coming back up through the stenosis, you again see the inflammatory nature of the stenosis. Here is a follow-up examination a few weeks later in the same patient after dilation or stretching open in the operating room. Notice again that the stenosis is clearly red and inflammatory in nature. This side-by-side before and after view makes it easier for you to see the difference the outpatient dilation procedure has made. The patient is thrilled to be able to breathe more easily, even though there is still some degree of stenosis evident in the after picture. Now, after dilation, an individual with this disorder may have relief of symptoms that last for months to even several years. It's variable. Unfortunately, at some point, as a rule, they again gradually develop that shortness of breath and they re-stenose. So the picture on the right returns gradually to the picture on the left over months or years. And then another dilation is performed, which is again equally effective in restoring breathing. Other options to this conservative management over time include the use of anti-inflammatory medication under the supervision of a rheumatologist and even removal of the narrowed area operatively and then sewing back together the remaining trachea and subglottis.